Joining me now in the studio is Kevin Richmond of the Sussex Community Fund. Welcome to you.
Hello, thank you.
You've been responsible for overseeing the fundraising for the Shoreham Airshow, I believe.
Yes, we have, yes.
And that's reached, what, £100,000?
It's just reached £100,000.
Yes. Pretty amazing.
It's been a fantastic response by the community. I think probably to correct you a little bit, we haven't been responsible for the fundraising. It's the community that's been responsible.
I was going to ask you about that, because really, what is your job? Is it to distribute the money?
Yes, yeah, so our job is really to distribute the money. Sussex Community Foundation is a charity for Sussex, which is a local grant maker. So we give grants to any kind of charitable cause, and we provide a service for our donors. But we were asked by the local authorities to run a fund to help those affected by the Shoreham disaster, because we could set it up really quickly and make sure the money gets to the people who most need it.
People who do their own thing are probably confusing the public, aren't they?
Well, I don't know. There are other funds that are raising money which are much more specific, and they've been set up by friends of particular families, and that's absolutely fine. But I think there was a sense that there were a lot of people who wanted to give to help people who were affected by the crash and didn't know where to give it. So by giving a central pot with a trusted charity, people know that money's going to be well spent. And it also gives people a bit of time, actually, to work out how best to spend that money.
Do you actually come under the banner of government or local authority?
No, we're an independent charity.
Completely independent.
We're a completely independent charity. We've been running for 10 years in Sussex. In that time, we've given out over £8 million across Sussex. We've funded over 2,000 charities.
So where did money come from originally, then, to set this up?
For the Community Foundation?
Yeah.
It comes from local people and local companies. So we have donors like American Express, Southern Water, Gatwick Airport have funded us in the past. But probably most of the money comes from local families. So people who've made money in the county and want to give back to the county. And we make it easy for them to do that.
And you cover both East and West Sussex. You're Sussex wide.
Yes, we cover everything from Fairlight to Midhurst, if you like, and everywhere. But the key thing about the Community Foundation is it gets to the grassroots of the community. It gets to small charities that most people don't know about, and it gets money where it's most needed.
I mean, a lot of people. Yeah. I've been around for a while. I've never heard of it before.
No.
only when the Shoreham disaster happened did I hear about it.
Well, in many ways, we are the best kept secret in Sussex.
You are, like.
Yeah, we are. We've grown over the last 10 years tremendously, and because a lot of what we do is actually very quiet and discreet in a way, because a lot of the families we work with don't want to be household names, they want to be quite quiet. But, I mean, actually, the charities in the community sector do know us very well now, because we have funded many charities, so people who are looking for funding locally know the Community Foundation quite well.
So why did they come to you for the air show?
They came to us, I think, because, we've made a plan, in a way, because a couple of years ago, when you're probably aware of the flooding that was happening all across the country, and in the Somerset Levels, there was a massive public appeal that raised over £1 million to help people affected by that. And Somerset Community Foundation was asked to manage that. And we thought, what would happen if we were asked to do that? That's a lot of money suddenly to manage very quickly. So we thought we'd better make a plan. So we started thinking about how we would respond if there was a disaster. And we spoke to the local authorities and said, look, if there is a disaster in Sussex that needs an immediate response in terms of managing money, we can do it.
Is money still coming in?
Money is still coming in. And it was the Monday morning after the crash that West Sussex County Council rang us and said, people are calling us wanting to give money. What can they do? Can you help? So we said, yes, we'll set up a fund right away. We set up a Just Giving page straight away. And from the first day, really, people were giving money. Within 2 days, £10,000 had been given. But it's just that tremendous response of the community just really seeing such a terrible thing happening. I think it's really touched so many people because, people living in Brighton Hove, it's so much on our doorstep.
How will this be distributed in the end?
It'll be, we've set up a grants panel, and what we've done immediately is the first priority is to help people who've been bereaved or people who've lost a family member with any emergency needs, because that's why people were giving the money. They want to help those in that terrible situation. So we've been working through social services and through the police family liaison officers to make sure the families know the money is there. And we've got a very quick, simple process so that people can come to us. And we've started giving out some grants.
You've already started.
Which means small things. But
is this purely to help those that are bereaved, or does it include the emergency services who have been affected tremendously by this?
There have been, and that's something that, that might happen down the line. The first priority for us, I think, is the bereaved families, because I think that's what people have been saying to us when they're giving the money. Beyond that, the phase one, if you like, is the bereaved families. Phase two is wider people affected, so people who may have been injured or people who've experience the trauma of witnessing the accident.
Okay, we'll come back and carry on if you don't mind.
Thank
after the break. I'm talking to Kevin Richmond, who's the CEO of the Sussex Community Fund. We're going to have a quick break. When I come back, we'll be talking more to Kevin. Please join us here and stay with us here at Latest TV. Welcome back to Latest TV's Big News Show, coming to you live from the heart of Brighton. My name's Mike Mendoza. I'm still joined in the studio by Kevin Richmond. Kevin is the CEO of the Sussex Community Fund. So far, £100,000 raised to help the victims of the Shoreham disaster and others possibly as well.
Yes, absolutely. Yes, and as I say, it's been a tremendous response from the community raising money. What we'll be doing immediately is helping the families that have been bereaved or have lost a loved one. And some grants have started to go out already for that. If there's funds left after that, we'll look at people who have been affected in the wider community as well.
I mean, all over the place, you're seeing people advertising, you know, we're raising funds for the Shoreham Airshow, the disaster, and making records, doing goodness knows what.
That's
should
right.
they be giving the money to your organisation, or what should they be doing with the money?
Well, we're an option. I mean, we're not, I'm not saying everyone should give to us, but we are a route for people to give to make sure that you know the money will be well managed, and we've got a grants panel that will make sure that we're making the best decisions about that money. Other people are raising things for particular families or for particular things related to the crash, and that's fine as well.
A lot of people collecting just saying, you know, we're going to help, but not knowing what they're going to do with the money or where to put it.
Yeah, that's right. So if you're not sure what you want to do, then this is the place. This is the place to give it.
Can you see some sort of lasting memorial somewhere around the area? That's not really your side, though, is it?
It's not really our side of it. I think our aim is really to help the people who've been affected by it. Mm-hmm. I think there are conversations going on about a long-term memorial. I mean, I would imagine that's something that probably we'd want to consult the families.
Where were you when the disaster happened? When did you first hear about it?
Well, actually, I was driving back from Southampton to go and watch the Albion.
Oh, really?
And I was on the
A27. You were held up
on the A27? If I stopped for a coffee, and if I hadn't done, I could have been there.
Really?
So I think that's common story, isn't it? A lot of people think, actually, you know, but for the grace of God, I could have been there, so...
How do people who are affected by the disaster contact you, or are the police organising this?
At the moment, they can contact us through police, family liaison officers or social services if you're in contact with them.
Is that what happened so far?
That's what happened so far, or through Citizens Advice Bureau, any other advisor. Or you can contact us directly. Our website is sussexgiving.org.uk. Our phone number is 01273 409 440. So people can just give us a call.
That number again?
01273 409 440.
Okay. So how can people who, not with this disaster, but in general, people who do need help, A, how do they contact you, and what sort of things do they come to you about?
Yeah. Well, the majority of our work is actually supporting small local charities and community groups. So we're a local grant maker, and we've got a very simple, straightforward process for grant making. We're not bureaucratic like most funders are. And similarly, you know, people can ring us up. They can look at our website, which is sussexgiving.org.uk. And it is very easy to apply. And if people are not sure about the application forms, they can ring us up and we'll help.
Is there a limit to what people can get?
Well, the majority of our funds for charities are up to £5,000. And most of our grants are small grants for small groups. But it really is a vast range of things that we've done. I mean, in Brighton and Hove, we've funded lots of groups working with elderly people, with our social groups, lunch clubs, youth groups for young people, groups working with the homeless, you name it. If people are doing it in the community, then we can help. We're very happy to support.
Yeah. As I said before, Sussex Community Fund, everyone knows about it now, but before they didn't. So how did they know about you before? Was this through other organisations?
Yes, well, I think in terms of charities finding us, we work very closely with people like Community Works in Brighton and Hove or Worthing Voluntary Action to make sure that they they're telling their members about us. We did try and get coverage in the newspapers when we can and things like that. So we spread the word. In terms of our raising money, we tend to do it very quietly. We do it much more through personal introductions rather than big fundraising events.
And do they have to be a registered charity to come to you, or can anybody else come to you?
No, one of the great things about a community foundation is we can fund anything that's charitable. So lots of groups come to us before they're ready to be a charity, and they're just a group of people wanting to make a difference in their community. Uh-huh. So we can do
startups. Groups of people as opposed to individuals who may have a problem?
Primarily we do groups of people, but obviously with things like the Shoreham Fund, we're funding individuals, and we do have some other funds, because what we do basically is we manage funds on behalf of our donors. So we have one or two donors who particularly want to award individuals.
How did you get involved in this?
I used to run.
Put you in the hot seat now.
Yeah, so I used to run the Carers Centre in Brighton and Hove.
All right.
I've done that for sort of 7 years. I've always worked in the volunteer sector, and I thought how difficult it is to raise money from local people, even as a charity that was fairly well known in the town. Local people didn't give to it, and then I saw the advert for the job of this community foundation that was going to make it easy for local people to give to local charities, and mm-hmm. I thought, we need that. I'll give it a go. Mm. And at that point, 10 years ago, it was an idea, and I thought, that's a great idea. But now, like I say, it's given out £8 million. And
fantastic.
We've got an endowment fund which is over £11 million, which means we're here for good. We will be increasingly a really core part of the community.
And are you a committee?
We've got a board of trustees who are all volunteers, all local people. And we've got a staff team of 7 people. It's a great organisation.
Is this a full-time job for you?
It's a full-time job, definitely. Yeah, very much, yes.
Yeah. So yeah, you have offices and what?
Yes, we've got a staff team of 7 people in Lewes, so they're all employed. But we also have many volunteers who help us across the county as well.
Okay, yeah. Well, thank you so much indeed.
Thank you very
much. Appreciate that. And good luck to you. Just once again, let's quickly go through how people can contact you.
Yes.
Online, maybe?
Yes. Yeah, online, our email address is info@sussexgiving.org.uk. Our website is sussexgiving.org.uk. And our phone number is 01273 409440.
Okay, lovely. And good luck to you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much indeed. And still raising funds, of course, for
absolutely,
the Shoreham Airshow,
yes.
Which has now hit £100,000. So well done to everybody for raising that sort of money.
Absolutely.
And good luck to you for managing it.
Thank you.
Well done.